Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to our channel. Once again, I would like to remind you all to please like and subscribe on our channel for more content on the latest celebrity gossip. Please join us. And today we are going to be talking about Conor McGregor. As we all know, Conor has a very, very notorious attitude. True to his name, actually. He flashed his genitals towards a married woman. But that's just not the first allegation that he has faced. He has faced a countless number of allegations against him. The latest allegations against former UFC champion Conor McGregor are disturbing, to say the least. The MMA superstar was arrested and interrogated by French police Saturday on allegations of sexual assault. Through his manager and a legal spokesperson, McGregor completely denied the allegations. A report said he allegedly exposed himself to a woman as she was heading to the restroom in a club. Assume for a second that we do believe denial that and that McGregor did not commit sexual assault. What is still disturbing is that he continually finds himself in these situations. As the saying goes, I mean, come on, guys. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. The New York Times reported on two occasions in 2019 that McGregor was under investigation for sexual assault in Ireland. He's gotten himself into trouble for punching an elderly man in a bar and breaking a fan's phone after leaving a nightclub. He can't be a hermit. This is in North Korea. We live in Europe, a democratic Europe, guys. And he can't be a hermit and stay in his home by himself all the time. But he needs to quit putting himself into situations where these allegations are made. He was recently engaged and has two young children with fiancée Dee Devlin. She doesn't deserve to have to go through this, and their kids certainly don't need to grow up hearing that their father is an alleged criminal. Conor, are you a criminal? UFC President Dana White said he doesn't know much about the allegation. I said he hasn't spoken to McGregor, but he tried to explain how popular McGregor is when asked about McGregor finding himself in these kinds of situations. Bros before hoes, right? The insinuation is that there are people who make these allegations in hopes of getting a settlement, knowing how well off McGregor is financially. I mean, the guy made almost $100 million after fighting Floyd Money Mayweather, baby. One time, when Conor blew up and Conor was massive, he showed up at the venue with so much security that I was like, this is pretty ridiculous. Nobody needs this much security. White said. I said, this kid's going to blow all of his money just to security. Then me and Lorenzo met up with him one night, and you just don't understand how big this is until you go out with him. He was literally getting mobbed. People were going crazy, screaming, jumping up from blackjack tables, leaving their money there and running after Conor. It was some crazy shit. I'm telling you guys, I never had seen anything like that. And imagine what it's like with him in Europe. There were all people freaking out when he would just walk by. It wasn't just young people, old people are freaking out too. That kind of a life, crazy shit happens when you're in that type of a lifestyle. You try to go out, be normal, and it's hard to do sometimes. I'm not defending Conor in any way, shape or form. I don't know enough about the situation to talk about it at all. But I do know that I have gone out with him before publicly, and it's bullshit nuts. That's what Dana White said. It's probably like it is when LeBron James or Tom Brady or Mike Trout or someone of that ilk is out in public, but you don't hear those kind of allegations against them. This isn't to allege that McGregor is committing crime, because I am not. But the frequency of this allegation is disturbing and seems to warrant a closer look by McGregor and his team about how we can venture into public safely. The best thing, clearly, is if he's fighting and he's active and thus not spending his nights in clubs. But Tim McGregor needs to devise a plan to make sure he's not in position for these kinds of allegations we made in the first place. Guys, as the saying goes, If you cannot hold your liquor, just don't drink at all, man. Don't drink, man. White had hoped to put together a Tony Ferguson-Dustin Poirier bout for the undercard of UFC 254, which features an interim lightweight title bout between champion Khabib, who kicked Conor's ass, by the way, and interim champion Justin in the main event. Poirier declined the fight for financial reasons, and White said that the UFC and Vegas 10 show and Apex situation is not salvageable, and that he's now looking for a new opponent for Ferguson. But if he doesn't, I favor Dan Hooker as Ferguson's next opponent. Both are coming off losses, Hooker to Poirier and Ferguson to Justin, and the fight will have a great deal of significance within the division. Well, so please, guys, if you dislike, if you like the content, please just like, subscribe, and please stay tuned for more content. And I'm please begging you, please, guys, subscribe and help this channel grow to 100,000 subscribers. May God bless you all, guys. Have a good night. You guys are the best. You're the best subscribers in the world. And may God bless you guys. Thank you.